Watch Scott get publicly humiliated.
3, 2, 1, yeah!
Head out on the high seas for a little fishing trip.
Oh, look at me, like a dog hanging his dumb fat head out the window.
Watch Spiegel show us how to shotgun a soda.
Crack it open, now tip it up.
Oh, no! Oh, God, it's going so bad!
All that and all the horrible things you hear when I sleep, coming up next.
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel?
The 98 Rock Morning Show?
Yep, I'm an idiot.
What is happening right now?
You pay me to talk!
What are they doing on my TV?
Justin, Scott, and Spiegel shouldn't be on TV.
Last week, you got to see the first Time Machine trivia payoff where Justin lost and I got to shave his head as punishment.
But for the second round of Time Machine trivia, the stakes are even higher.
Will Justin lose again? Or will Scott be humiliated?
Dun, dun, dun.
Take a look.
The loser will have to pay off a humiliating debt in front of a crowd of thousands next month at JSS DeVol at Meet Cute Pavilion. That humiliating debt is a full spray tan with the darkest legally allowed orange body spray. You'll have to wear a thong and kimono and be pulled around by nipple rings and a chain. Nipple clamps attached to a chain.
The chain and the clamps are on live wire right now if you'd like to see them, and they hurt.
The current score is 104, Justin. Scott has 101. 2, 3, 4. That's a 3-point difference, Justin, in the lead. I guess it all depends on your first one. You'll know. David Bowie, according to Scott, and David Bowie, according to Justin.
Okay.
The correct first song. Betty Davis Eyes.
All right. We both got it wrong. Comes down to the wager.
Okay. Well, I went ahead and wagered 25 points.
That's right. So that means you're
down.
That means
I'm down to 76.
Oh, God.
I have a total of 76.
Oh, okay, my God. 76 points.
Justin has 104. You wagered.
Justin wagered 0.
0! Yeah.
Oh, my God. He's running around the room. He's holding a chair over his head. Nothing pretty about floating. There's nothing pretty about floating.
He's not gloating, he's celebrating.
Coming up next.
Oh, yes! He will reveal himself upon the count of 3, 2.
Well, I did it. I lost the second Time Machine trivia payoff to Justin. And here it is. Never before seen footage of me from the JSS Festival paying off my debt. I got a spray tan, nipple clamps, and a ball gag. It's awful. My parents are super proud. And as you'll see, I'm super fat.
So ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the S in the center of JSS, a man of his word, Long Island's favorite son, now Baltimore's favorite bitch. Scott Reardon. Oh, yes. He will reveal himself upon the count of 3, 2, 1. Yes! Spin. There you go, Gimp. There you go, Gimp. There you go. Oh, that's daddy's little boy. That's daddy's little boy. Hey, hey, $20. You can do whatever you want to. Hey, I'll start the bidding at $20.
It's been like, it's been amazing. People love it. I'm happy I did it. I'm fat. I'm tan. I'm a turbo slut. But the response has been amazing.
You know, I've never been a big drinker, but sometimes this job.
Oh, man. Well, we want the news genius to loosen up a little bit, so we try to get him drinking maybe through some less traditional means.
So with the help of our friend Megan, we taught Spiegs how to shotgun a beer, or in our case, a soda.
I don't understand why it has to be open like that. Why can't you just drink it from the normal?
No, it's all about physics. This is how you... And then you crack the top of the can. The air goes in the top. The seltzer comes out the bottom. He's not going to be able to do this.
Send engineering in. They want to watch this. And here we go.
Oh!
Oh! Get it!
Oh.
Get it!
Oh!
Yes!
Yes, Gaddy!
Woo! Megan's going for the iced tea. Here she goes.
You're going to get iced tea all over you.
Get it! Get it!
Oh, there's iced tea dripping down her breast.
It's so hot. Yeah! All right, there you go. Now, Josh, place it to your lips, put it up in the air, pop the top, get sucking.
You got to crack the thing. No, you got to crack it.
Not yet.
Put it to your lips.
Put it to your mouth. And
then now, crack it and tip it up.
Tip it up. Tip it up.
Crack it open. Now, tip it up.
Oh,
no.
Oh,
tip
it. Oh, God, it's going so bad. Oh, no. Oh,
no. It's not.
No.
Wait, hold on.
Oh, no.
Keep going. That's the object. Keep going. How much did he get done with?
Here, you can tell how much I need.
Oh, yeah.
Three quarters?
Three quarters? Does that count?
Half?
Finish it.
Don't let a beer go unwasted. There he goes. Yes.
There you go.
There he goes.
This is the longest shotgun on the planet. He's still going.
He's eating the metal.
It should normally take 3 to 4 seconds. This is about... Come on over. Talk to us.
The taste is not great, but it was all right.
It's LaCroix or LaCroix or whatever the hell it is. It sucks.
I mean, I don't know what the after effects are going to be.
What do you mean? You just drank seltzer water. Nothing. No. What are you talking about? What after effects?
It's not a result.
What are you talking about?
Coming up next.
We got one. Justin's fishing.
That's the first time in history a man in a leopard print shirt has ever cracked crabs.
Recently, myself, Scott, and Josh got to hang out with two of our favorite bands. We took the Glorious Sons fishing, and we taught the UK band The Struts how to pick a Maryland blue crab.
Fishing with the Glorious Sons.
Oh, yes.
That chin.
Out on the Chesapeake, name of the boat, heavy metal, Glorious Sons. There's our winner, James Hackman. I'll tell you what, a day I went into semi-dreading.
Is it because you're trapped and you can't leave?
You're trapped, you can't leave, you don't know how long you're going to be out there.
Well, you can leave, you're just going to drown. Oh, look at me, like a dog hanging his dumb fat head out the window. Just getting some of that nice Chesapeake Bay bacteria directly up my nose and eyes. I got pink eye 24 hours later after this.
Yeah, that's why you see people that are on boats regularly, they don't normally do that.
Yeah, you can tell I'm not on a boat regularly.
Sig Hansen, you'll never see him doing that.
No one on Deadliest Catch hangs
has
their
ever done that.
God, look at my... thin eyes, slow
face, hair.
Wispy hair.
Wispy. So wispy.
God, it's so bad.
You know, there's Brett from the Glorious Sons. Now, did you think when they showed up they were going to look like rock stars? Because that is not a rock star outfit.
I was
happy that he wore that. I was like, oh, look. He's ready to go on a boat.
He's wearing boxer shorts.
Oh, and look at this.
Oh, we got one on!
We got one on! We got one! Justin's fishing!
We got one on!
Okay,
and I gave you a hard time for reeling because you said it was so hard to reel. But then when you see what the hell you pulled up, it was like one of these giant rigs that had like 47 lines on it. And that's why it was so hard to reel in, because it was this big-ass rig.
Yeah, it was like an entire like metal shop under the water. Wait. This thing was hard to reel.
Wait till you see the size of this fish.
Look
Man,
at
you
the
should
monster.
Be so proud.
I should have hung this on the wall.
I was going to say, have you had it mounted yet?
Well, find out why I didn't in a few moments. Look at this beast. How many families is it? And that's it.
It's not bad.
Yeah. Look at that.
It's like when you go to when you're in bed with a woman and they see it and they go, it's cute.
It's the size I wanted it to
it's
be.
It's cute.
I think it's all about the effort.
You never want it to be called cute.
Ever. You just wanted it to be called gargantuan.
Oh, there they go. They're measuring it.
They're
something
measuring
we've all done.
Yeah, yeah.
We've all measured.
I've never taken that much tape measure out myself.
Now, Justin, hold your fish.
I'm going to hold it.
Hold your fish proudly.
Look,
hold
I'm
it.
Doing
watch.
Great.
Hold it proudly.
Look at me.
Let's get
Dad.
A picture
I'm
of it.
I'm going to
mount
it.
Hold on. Wait. Let me get.
Gonna...
Oh, wait. Oh!
No!
Oh, what happened there?
My tiny little baby hands couldn't hold on to it. I've got tiny toddler hands.
He's free to swim again.
Do you know how badly I wanted to dive overboard and either go get it or stay down there? I just look at Brett pat me on the shoulder like, oh, it's sweet. You guys brought a handicapped kid with
you. All right, but let's say this. That's a better story.
So here we are. We just got off the boat with the Glorious Sons, one
right.
half of the JSS Festival, and then we hightail it over to Jimmy's Famous Seafood, best crab house in the country, to then hang out with the other band from the JSS Festival, the Struts, who we are going to teach how to pick and eat crabs. Here we go. Now, let's get to the band themselves. The Struts, these guys, you know, Britain's finest, are all dressed up. They've got, like, sashes on. They've got the leopard print. That's a rock star haircut.
That's the first time in history a man in a leopard print shirt has ever cracked crabs.
Ever. No one has 100%. Ever worn that
Never.
Pattern and
Never.
Eaten crabs before. These guys behind the scenes were awesome. None of them acted like rock stars. They were drinking beers or eating crabs or hanging out at our favorite crab house. No one gave us like a rock star diva moment at all.
Have you ever had like real crabs, like crab, like the disease?
Like crab crab?
Like, I mean, what's it called? What are they called?
This isn't going to air on TV. Will
it? No, this won't be on TV.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I had a dose last week.
What do you do in that case? Do you shave them all off? Or
Ride
do you...
it out, brother. Ride it out.
Special shampoo,
you know,
or
hate?
Shave them? Or?
They hate Parmesan. I just sprinkle Parmesan. Same thing in your pasta, put it on your unmentionables, and they just run for the hills.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, boy, I've had all kinds of stuff before. This is definitely not going to be
No, this won't
God.
Be
Oh, God. I mean, the rickets, scurvy, syphilis, hepatitis A, B, C, D, E. I'm a walking biology experiment. And back to the crabs here. There I am just wrecking those things, spitting out shells.
Level with me real quick for 1 second.
No, please.
As our video cuts off. I just saw the something. The white watch that I wear. Just be honest with me. Brutally honest. Is the white watch, should I just throw that away? Or is it okay?
I love it. I honestly do. I really like it. It's a nice watch. Yeah!
Coming up next.
This app right here is called the Sleep Talk app. The way it works, you turn it on, you set it beside your bed before you go to bed, and in the middle of the night, it will record anything you say or any noises that you make.
And our man Josh Spiegel has provided us with hours and hours of entertainment. Take a look.
For the record, most of the sounds were from my dog.
Let's go ahead and enjoy ourselves fresh Sleep Talk audio.
It's very good.
Let me preface this. I'm actually awake in that cut. I'm talking to my dog. I didn't realize the Sleep Talk was still on.
Okay, let me play that clip again real quick.
So I'm baby talking.
Oh, okay, so this is awake talk.
It's very good. It's good. You're very good. You're good, baby.
You say you're very rude?
I'm very,
you're very rude.
I said he's very rude.
You're very rude,
because he had just scratched me on the face.
Oh, you're very rude.
Very rude.
Wow.
Hello.
Oh. That's, I'm asleep there.
It sounds like it. Yeah, baby. Oh,
are you having a nocturnal emissions?
Oh, no, yeah. Are you sure? It sounds like it. Okay, hold on one more time.
Our sisters are in a gigantic...
I feel like he says they're part of a gigantic conspiracy against you. We got so much more to go, I'm so happy.
This is so evil.
Ooh. Jesus, dude. Here goes.
I don't see the humor in it. That was an up fart.
That is whatever it is emerging from is so tiny. Oh my God, that is a tiny backside. Oh God. Okay. Oh, I'm sorry, Hannah. All of these are savable. Big clip coming up here. Big clip action.
Don't tell us. Is this my dog? Would you? This may be the highlight.
Look at the size of this waveform.
I see it.
Here we go.
Where did Scott go? He just ran down the hall. You didn't even hear the whole thing.
Oh my God.
You ran out of here. I was surprised when I heard that. I was like, wow, that's amazing.
I'm dead. That's a 3.5 second rip. That is a 3.5 second rip. Here you go. Listen to it.
Coming up next.
You keep buzzing around my ear. Yeah. I'll tell you what.
What?
Yeah, take this.
Just breaking legs.
Welcome to the cubicle where I compose my news each morning. I'm going to share one of the gems from this week. And first, let me show you around. There's a computer I never use, along with a dust-covered fan. There's a picture of my dog, Farfel, a phone. When it rings, I hang up on the people that call because I don't like them. There's a calendar with a giant animal on it. There's a library, books I do not read, but it's for aesthetic purposes. Here's a drawer with a stapler, and that's about it. Let's take a look at that gem of a story.
Swatting, pests, and summertime go together like hot dogs and mustard. But a new study might make you feel guilty about splatting an annoying bug buzzing around your barbecue. Researchers from Australia's University of Sydney say they have found that insects that survive your swat live the rest of their lives with chronic pain.
Oh my God.
While it was already known insects could feel what we humans perceive as pain, the fact that pain from the injuries would linger in insects is something new.
Good.
Researchers say the experiment centered on the humble fruit fly. These sadistic researchers damaged the legs of the fruit flies and then allowed the insects to heal. However, after the injuries healed, the flies' legs remained sensitive in the same way your bum knee has never been the same since you hurt it back in the day. And like you, the bugs tended to baby that busted appendage afterwards. That's it. No more swatting insects in my home.
So there's someone who just weeks upon weeks sat in a lab breaking fruit fly legs.
Got another one for you.
Jesus.
Hey,
it was this guy's job. What do you do? I go into a lab and I break fruit flies' legs all day.
What's your name? Frankie the Fly.
Oh! I got a message from Uncle Tony.
What's that?
Oh! Hey, you better get him his money.
That's what you get for landing on my nephew.
You better get him his money or it's going to be the other one next week.
I promise not to land on your wife's shoulder anymore.
Oh, I know.
Oh!
Hey, you keep buzzing around my ear. Yeah. I'll tell you what.
What?
Yeah, take this.
Ow! Ow!
Just breaking legs.
Oh!
This is a fruit fly. How small is a fruit fly leg?
Very tiny.
Oh! How do you even do that?
With the world's tiniest hammer.
Oh! Really? Oh! Let them heal?
No.
And they just
They got very tiny hospital beds.
Oh!
And the leg is elevated.
Yeah, in one of those things.
And there's a little tiny nurse
with those things like this blowing.
Oh, can I have some more morphine, please?
You want to sign my tiny cast?
Ow! He's got these little mini baseball bats and whack! Whack him in the knee.
This is for you.
Ow! Ow! What is this? Why?
Why? How many millions did they spend on
research?
This?
How much did they fund this stupid study?
How many bridges could we rebuild or space missions we plan to find out that my local centipede gets sore?
Please stop! I'm going to see what happens when I throw a dragonfly down the stairs.
Check it out!